And welcome back to Let's Play Mass Effect 2 Blind. We just finished up with the Pylos Nebula. For real this time. Done. Dorada. Canalis is the planet that I almost missed. Geth were messing with the weather on the planet. I really have no idea why they'd want to do that. But we stopped them. So let's head. I think our fuel is good, yes. Let's head back to the mass relay. We can help Jack. We can rescue this doctor. I don't even remember who the hell that is. It's from way back. We could do all this. I'm gonna do this right now. Help Jack, or at least head towards helping Jack. Check out some systems. Right, so what system is this again? Or cluster, rather? The Nubian Expanse. Apparently, there's three systems. Kalapsha, Kurtasi, and we're in Daka. Now, I'm not going to go to help Jack just yet, actually. I'm going to check out some of these other systems. These usually turn into, like, 1 hour, maybe an hour and a half affairs. So I'm going to hold off because, again, it's getting late and I can't get into it right now. But I can knock off an episode or two by looking at these planets and maybe get into a little mini-adventure, something like that. As will sometimes happen. Bannock is a large superterrestrial hothouse with a crushing carbon dioxide atmosphere. A high average density of over 7 grams per cubic centimeter indicates that Bannock is a mineralogical treasure trove. If only there were some way to safely reach its seas of molten metal and loads of radioactives. The planet's mass is so great that trace amounts of helium and molecular hydrogen can be found in the atmosphere. Rich in resources, not a surprise from the description there. Let's see if we find anything, element zero anyway. I do have large spikes of other minerals, but or elements. But no Ezo that I can see. Froggy and I'm gonna check that out yet. Ulkanost. Ulkanost is a standard ice giant with a methane ammonia atmosphere. It has an unusually strong magnetic grid, which is occasionally useful when ships need to discharge their drives. So funny how they have to do that constantly. We hear a lot of talk of that. Discharging their drives. Helium 3, I guess. Didn't think we'd find any here in a gas giant. But I had to try. Gamayan. Gamayan is a hydrogen helium gas giant with 6 large icy moons. The outermost one, Gigula, is of note for a well-preserved wreckage of an ancient starship that was recovered by a Turian military surveyor. Little information has been released to the public on the vessel, aside from a scholarly paper regarding how the internal layout suggests a horizontally oriented race. That's one way of putting it. Never heard that before. A horizontally oriented race. I guess it's a little more, if you say bipedal, I mean, how do we know how many legs they have, actually? So they stand horizontally. is one way of distinguishing them from creatures who do not. And not finding anything here. Alright. Poor to begin with. There's these other planets. I must find you. That one's there. Where's the other one? Oh, the other one, never mind, is the mass relay. Looking for a planet that doesn't exist. Zernitra. Cold, distant Zernitra has an extremely low density and is thought to be mainly water ice around a small rocky core. It has little to recommend it. Rich. Ezo here. Nope. So, Praggy is the only one left, and much as I would love to get into that right now, I can't. I do not have time. Be ill-advised at this juncture. Kurtasi, let's check that out. Oh my. Look at that sun. One planet. Noressa. Noressa is an unremarkable methane ammonia ice giant with a small family of icy moons. It is likely that the Kurtasi system had additional worlds earlier in its history, but these have been swallowed by the aging giant star. Kurtasi is an elderly, metal-poor population 2 star, broadly similar to Arcturus. Interesting. So I guess the sun is in the process of the going supernova. Which I'm pretty sure people think of as a quick kind of thing. You know, like a blast, but it kind of lasts for the whole process of going supernova, and then when it's over it collapses into normally a white dwarf star. Extremely long process. Alright, that's Kurtasi. Kalabsha. 2 planets. Oh my. We're gonna have to take this mission on, aren't we? Yam. With... Yam. With over 90% of its surface covered in oceans, Yam is a habitable nitrogen-oxygen world, but its extremes can be quite hostile to sapient life. The heat from its extremely long days reaches dangerous levels, ranging from 24 Celsius at night to 53 in the afternoon in the temperate zones. Hurricanes run unchecked across the oceans, with winds reaching up to 250 kilometers per hour. While there are some arthropod-like animals, the predominant forms of life are various kinds of toxic algae blooms that stretch hundreds of kilometers across. However, other biohydrocarbon algae blooms are suitable for use as biofuel, and farming the green gold forms the backbone of Yam's economy. Colony founded in 2170 CE, population 488,504. Capital is New Karnak. Check it out. Alright, everything but Ezo there. What you got against that Ezo, huh? Here you go. Yay!
Launching probe.
So now we got our flag, so we know when we've come full circle. we go.
Launching probe. Probe launched.
So, looks like we're going to have to start Jack's thing. Maybe I won't get as much sleep as I want to. I'm not sure I can get it any higher than that. Nope.
Probe launched.
It's a twofer.
Launching probe.
All right, so we're done. These are some pretty small systems. Tefnut. A hydrogen helium gas giant, Tefnut is home to a Helium 3 collection and the nearest refueling facility to the Nubian Expanse's mass relay. As such, it is a major gateway to the Verge and Terminus systems and has become famous for its hospitality industry. Tefnut's motto is known throughout the galaxy, like home, only better. Visitors here can stay at expansive resort stations. I guess they're in orbit around the planet, right? Yeah. Watch locally produced entertainment by mind-affecting substances not welcome in Citadel space, and rent companionship. Resources are shipped in from Yam at substantial discounts, allowing the small space stations to have surprising luxuries such as edible arthropods and large amounts of fresh water. Population 33,810, 10 spread across 5 space stations. Interesting, huh? Sounds like they give Omega 3 some competition. All right, Jack, fine. Can't end the episode like 13 minutes in. That's 100. We will help out Jack and finish up the Nubian Expanse in one fell swoop. Fuel depot. A few probes. And Pragya. The jungle planet Pragya is overrun by choking hypergrowth caused by industrial mutated plant species. This, combined with its relative isolation and lack of population, has made Pragya an occasional base of operations for drug runners, weapon smugglers, pirates, mercenaries, terrorists, and intelligence agencies seeking secrecy. Sustained habitation on Pragya is extremely difficult, where mutant and even poisonous plant life can overgrow colonies in days instead of years. We're going to be fighting plants here. We can't scan the surface for anything. Gravity's a little less than out of Earth. It's a pretty nice temperature. Pressure and day length, rather similar. Yeah, let's land. Of course, Jack is our only option here. You know what'd be interesting? Bring Samara. I'd like to see if she has any interaction with Jack or anything like that. Any reaction to anything that might happen that Jack might do, such as that. Such as it is. Been a while since I played with Jack. Sounded wrong. Yeah, she's got some points to use up. Her heavy pull is maxed out. Let's take a subject zero. And then I could either give her evolved shockwave, which I'd probably give her improved, or subject zero. Reduce the charge time or increase her weapon damage. Reduce the recharge time. I'm not sure if I said increase. Let's take the shockwave. Improve shockwave. I find the distance to be fine. Improved shockwave. I mean, that's what I have, and I usually stay way back.
I forgot how much I hate this place. See the landing pad? Has to be on the roof, or the vegetation would overgrow it in a few hours.
Shepard, I am picking up thermal signatures everywhere, except at your landing zone.
Something's distorting the sensors.
This was a secret Cerberus facility.
Yeah. They build their equipment to last. Assholes. It was a mistake coming back here, Shepard.
Settle down.
Get a hold of yourself. It'll be okay.
I'm fine. Okay, let's get on the ground.
So why exactly build this place here? Surely it's a more habitable planet. Pragya. We got Codex.
Humans detected Aiea as an Earth type. Originally choked by the hypergrowth of non-native plant species, Pragya serves as a galactic reminder about the imperative for careful regulation during colonization. 2 centuries ago, Batarian agribusiness chose uninhabited Pragya as their empire's breadbasket. Colonization authorities introduced non-native, industrially mutated plants that flourished in the world's fertile volcanic soil. Synergizing with Pragya's natural geothermal conditions and chemotropic microbes, the imported species soon became a nightmare. Mutant strains of poisonous and even carnivorous plants arose, overgrowing colonies in days instead of years, and causing the Batarians to abandon their holdings. Because the planet's small animal population is insufficient to check its plant growth, Alliance ecologists predict soil exhaustion in 400 years. Due to its relative isolation and lack of population, Pragya has become a regional haven for drug runners, weapon smugglers, pirates, mercenaries, terrorists, and intelligence agents seeking secrecy.
Okay, so that's why. Relatively isolated and lack of population. Alright. Well, that answers my question. Anything in secondary? I love being caught up with the Codex. It's freaking awesome. So that is good to know. Just checking around for any goodies. And I can't go on that. That noise. I hear stuff. No idea what it is, but I hear stuff.
Let's just get in there and plant the bomb in my cell. I want to watch this place burn.
Huh. I don't think it's gonna be that easy. Enter the Telltin facility to find her old cell. That's what it is? She just wants to blow the place up? Don't get stuck on things. There's a terminal to hack over there.
I never saw this room. I think they brought new kids in these containers. They were messed up and starving, but alive. Usually. This is unbelievable.
Lock terminal. Is there a way in here as well? Oh, it's not anything. Well, let's see what's at this terminal and avoid that. Green with some. Here we go. Credits. There's going to be something important, but 3,000 credits will do.
Nobody left but us.
I don't count on it. I just feel it's stupid to walk around with my gun out all the time.
The elusive man requested operation logs again. He's getting suspicious.
When we get results, he won't care what we did. But if he knew...
He won't find out. The elusive man requested operation logs again. He's getting suspicious.
When we get results, he won't care what we did. But if he knew...
He won't find out. The elusive man requested operation logs again. He's getting suspicious.
When we get results, he won't...
Sounds as if this facility turned rogue. He didn't say what they were hiding from the elusive man.
Yep, he did not say.
I remember escaping to this room, fighting here. I saw sunlight through the cracks in the ceiling. Only a half-dead guard between me and freedom. He was begging for his life.
I don't imagine you spared it. Wondering if we're gonna have to fight plants. Lock storage crate. Where? What you got for me? 3,000 credits again. Came from there, right? Think so? Yeah. Can't save at this point. Gonna get attacked by a tree? or what? Well, we took our guns out and we can't save.
They've seen us.
Oh my god. Oh, Varen. Because I'm the Duke of Earth! Well, I was wondering what we were going to be fighting. Can save again. Old bloodstain. You been here, Jack?
This looks like an arena.
That's right. They used to stage fights here, pit me against other kids. I loved it. Only time I was ever out of my cell.
Wow. I'm pretty smart to figure out this arena. It just looks like a bunch of junk. How often did you fight here?
How often did they do this?
I was in a cell my whole life. Sometimes they took me out and made me fight. Filled me with drugs, other stuff. Time gets funny in a cell.
Why did they have you fight?
What were they studying?
Hell if I know. Maybe that's how they got their kicks. I never understood anything that happened here.
Short and to the point with these answers. And what were the nature of these fights?
Did other children die in these fights?
I was a kid, filled with drugs. I got shocked when I hesitated. Narcotics flooded my veins when I attacked.
That's sick.
What the hell was wrong with those people?
I don't know. Doesn't matter now.
So they conditioned you to fight?
They actually rewarded you for attacking.
I still get warm feelings during a fight.
Oh my god. Alright, Jack, you're even making me a little uneasy now, and I actually find you interesting somehow.
Let's keep moving.
Hell yes.
She gets warm feelings when she fights. Alright, just keep our guns out, because I don't know what's the other end of this door, or other side of this door. It's a med kit! Get it!
We got them all.
Plus one metagel, good to use up the one I used. Security console.
Security Officer Zimkle, Telton facility. The subjects are out of their cells. They're tearing the place up. Subject Zero is going to get loose. I need permission to terminate. I repeat, permission to terminate.
All subjects besides Zero are expendable. Keep Jack alive.
Understood. Huh. I'll begin to...
That's not right. I broke out when my guards disappeared. I started that riot.
Maybe there was more to it.
Things might have happened that you didn't see.
The other kids attacked me. The guards attacked me. The automated systems attacked me. That doesn't leave lots of room for interpretation.
Okay, lady. For anyone sapient remains here. What's that?
This place is supposed to be empty. Who the fuck shot that Baron?
The Baron.
It's a fresh kill.
There's a dead end. There's a door, right? Let's see what's behind the door. what you got. Okay. Yeah, I thought it was just a small little cell. 500 element zero. Cool. And we continue down this way. I'm like not putting my gun away because I have a feeling I have to take it right back out again. This cover.
We've been spotted.
Oh, we got Blood Pack. Our black metal friends are here.